Thank you for joining Pioneer. My name is Aaron Pence. I'm from the Norman Central Library. I appreciate you spending a few minutes with me today. Today, we're doing something fun. We're changing our backdrop. There are two things I want you to see today. First is how to change to a different backdrop, and second is how to make your own. When you're telling a story, it's important to give your audience some things that look different. It keeps the eye interested and the mind engaged. And a simple way to do that is with a changing backdrop.
Back in Scratch, let's start by adding two backdrops to our stage. Click the Choose a Backdrop button in the bottom right, and then pick a backdrop. I like this Castle 3 right here. Now, I want to add a second one right away. Click the Choose a Backdrop button again, and pick another backdrop. I think I'll take the mountain. Now that we have those backdrops in our stage, we can use them in our scripts, and it's pretty easy. Make sure you've selected your cat sprite in the bottom right. The block that switches the backdrop is the Switch Backdrop To block in the Purple Looks category. Grab it and snap it to the bottom of your script. Tell it to switch to the mountain backdrop by clicking the little bubble that says Backdrop 1 and changing it to Mountain. If you run your program now, like I'm running mine, you'll notice that nothing changes. If you think about it, it makes sense. The program is already set on Mountain as its backdrop. When it switches to Mountain from Mountain, nothing changes. It'd be like if you went to change your shirt and put the same shirt back on. Who could tell the difference? So what we need is to switch to the Castle 3 backdrop at the start so that we can switch to the Mountain only when it's time. Grab a second Switch Backdrop To button, but this time, snap it in right under your When Green Flag Clicked hat block. Change the Backdrop 1 bubble to read Castle 3. Now, run your program. Great, that's how you switch backdrops. Now, let's make our own. I'm not much of an artist, so there's only a little bit I can tell you here. But I can show you the basic steps to making your own backdrops. It's fun. First, point at the Choose a Backdrop button, but don't click. This time we want to select the little paintbrush icon, the one that says Paint if you stay pointed at it for just a second. That takes us to Scratch's Backdrop Editor. You can do all sorts of cool painting here. I'm going to harness my generational artistic skills to make a quick little sun and sky. First, I'm going to use the Rectangle tool right here. All the tools for painting are over here on the left. I click on the rectangle tool to select it, and then I need to select the color I'd like to use. There's like every color ever in here, so take your time and get it right. I'll pick blue for my sky. Then I'm going to turn off the outline. I don't want a black border around my sky. Click the outline button right here, and pick the little red slash to turn the border off. Then all you need to do is draw. Click and drag your rectangle into being over in the little checkerboard. You can also watch me make little adjustments by clicking and dragging on these little dots on the border so that I can get my sky just right. Once you're done, click somewhere else in the drawing to finish your sky rectangle. I'm going to do the same thing again for the ground. First, by selecting a groundier color like green and drawing a second rectangle. Now I'm going to adjust it to get it how I like it. Notice that it doesn't matter if I overlap the blue sky a little bit. It just looks groundy. Click somewhere else in the drawing to finish your ground rectangle. Last, I'd like to add a sun. I need a yellow circle for that. Click the circle tool on the left. Change it to a nice bright yellow. And click and drag to make a circle. You can move the position of the circle if you need to by clicking and dragging on the circle in your drawing. If you make a mistake you don't like, you can change it back by clicking this little undo arrow right here. It's great. And that's it. You've made your own backdrop. Give it a good name right here in this blank, like sunny day. And then click on the code tab right here to go use it.
And now you know how to use backdrops in Scratch. Backdrops are a great tool to make your story look awesome. Next time, we're going to learn a few tricks to move our sprites during our story for some really cool effects. Thanks a lot. See you soon.